it's been a different feel, you know, with being on a non-factory team this year. And it's been really fun, though, with the team being based here out of MTF. And we were even actually running the race shop out of my house for a couple months. So it's been really cool. The vibe is awesome. I'm really happy to be back at the races and competing with the guys. And, you know, it's I'm not exactly where I want to be yet as far as, you know, my speed and my fitness go on the track for race day. I'm there for practice days, but got to figure out that race day vibe again. But, man, it's fun just being back and competing.
When Yuriev and I were talking a couple months ago, he really had his eye on you. I mean, he really, really wanted to have you. After the couple years that you've had, to see that you still are so desirable, that you have all of these traits that, like you said, you've been down here for so long at MTF and you've ridden at the top of the sport and you've battled for championships. It's got to be nice to know that someone still sees that in you when you've had a couple rocky seasons.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, it's not the first time that I've kind of been, you know, down even in my pro career. After my first 2 years with Geico, you know, I came in with really high expectations. And then my first two pro years with Geico didn't go, you know, I would say to plan. I had one podium and a lot of crashes, and, you know, there was plenty of days where I'm like, can I do this, you know? And then I got a little bit of breath of fresh air with TLD, and you know, I went from being really low and a lot of people not believing in me to literally 1 year later having the points lead going into Vegas, you know, and then the next year also battling for a championship. So, you know, I've had some injuries the last few years, but I feel like this is kind of my breath of fresh air again here with Yuriev. Yuriev believed in me and Martin, and having my practice mechanic that has been my practice mechanic for the last 10 years is now my race mechanic. So it's really cool. You know, it's been a good vibe, and I'm just glad that I got a good opportunity.
There's all these little things in the 2 days that I've been here that I've seen, like, wow, this is just perfectly lined up for Jordon. Like you said, the race shop was here, your house isn't far away, it's MTF, but for you to be around guys like Martin, your mechanic, all of these guys that know you the day in, day out, it's not like you're having to relearn personalities or all this stuff. You guys understand what's going to happen.
Yeah, we do. We do understand it. I think it's, you know, I've gotten better throughout my career on being able to, you know, not demand what I want, but, you know, talk to the teams and stuff about what I want on the bike or whatever it is. But, like, you know, here it's really easy because, you know, my practice mechanic's like my brother. You know, we may not say it the nicest way to each other, but we know what each other wants, you know, and same with Martin, you know, like we were training together the last few years. So he really knows what, you know, whenever I say something, like, he knows what I want. So it's just trying to get that stuff and get it done in a timely manner. And yeah, so it's been good.
You know, you and Martin have had a lot of similar trajectory, being down here, being around Brian, Colleen, same group of people, riding for Mitch, understanding the expectations and the pressure and what everybody else does. To have someone that just gets it has got to be a nice thing in the position that he's in, because he understands, he's a racer. He knows the highs and lows of it just like anything.
Yep. Yeah, it is. It's really nice. He's definitely hard on us. Like, he doesn't take it easy. Like, with him being a racer before, it's not like he feels bad for us or anything, that's for sure. So but it's good. It's kind of hard sometimes because he was almost like so good at things, and like, if you can't get it, he's like, why can't you get it, you know? But no, it's been really good with Martin. He's been awesome, and you know, he's helped us a lot with the testing. Whenever Factory Connection was here, I was, you know, trying to explained something that I was feeling in the forks in particular, and I was like, Martin, will you ride my bike and see what you think about it? And he felt the same thing, but he was able to explain it in a different way, and with my way and his way of explaining it, the suspension guys were like, oh, we know exactly what to change, you know. And it was like, bam, like in the next setting it was like perfect. So that's been really cool also.
Okay. It's been like, you know, we all know, tough couple of years to get over injuries, not being at 100%. How do you feel right now?
Yeah, I feel good. You know, I had a really good off season, and that's been a rarity for me throughout my career. So yeah, I just had, you know, a lot of months of riding and stuff, and I felt really good, you know, going into the first round. Like, my fitness is really good. I've been working really hard in the gym. My speed has been good, but it's kind of one of those things, like, I didn't know how good my speed was. We had rode with the Star guys a couple days, and it was pretty good against Jeremy and Levi. But, you know, going into the first round, you don't really know exactly where you're going to be, you know? And I think through the first two races, I think that I haven't exactly shown the speed that I'm riding at practice, just that comfortability. So just trying to get that back, and it'll come with experience, or not experience, but just track time at the races. It's still a work in progress, but I'm really excited with where we're at through two races.
How does it feel to be where you're at health-wise? No lingering issues, no nagging problems. Yeah, there are going to be things that are always going to hurt, you know, but it's not racing through injury because you have to right now.
Right. Yeah, it's man, it's been really good. It's there's been a couple injuries the last few years that, like, I really wasn't sure, like, if we were ever going to get them figured out, like, if I was ever going to be able to race a dirt bike again, like, and they were just really small injuries that shouldn't have me worried about that. But, you know, in 2019 I hurt my wrist and had MRIs, x-rays. They couldn't find anything wrong with it, and, you know, I tried to race, couldn't. I gave it, I think I gave it 6 weeks off during Supercross, tried to come back for outdoors, and it was okay, but it was still bothering me quite a bit. I did the first couple rounds, and then I couldn't ride anymore. My hand was going numb, and it's at Colorado that year, it started hurting so bad. I couldn't ride, so I got a surgery on it. 2 months after the surgery, it was still hurting me just as bad. Like, I couldn't move my wrist hardly at all. And so I went and got a second opinion with another doctor. He didn't see anything wrong with it either, but he put me in a brace for a month, told me just don't move it. I went back to see him, took the brace off. It was worse. And I'm like, man, like, what are we going to do? And he's like, well, obviously there's something going on in there. So let's go in there, see what we see. And it was just built up with, like, a ton of scar tissue. Like, he said he had never seen anything like it before. So he cleaned that up, did a lot of rehab, like, right away with it, getting it moving so that scar tissue wouldn't build back up. And started back riding. That was my first year of PC, and my wrist was pretty good. And then my second year of PC, I hurt my thumb, and I tore a ligament in it that is, it's the UCL, ulna collateral ligament. And so I went to that same doctor. He's like, yeah, it probably needs surgery. It's a pretty simple surgery. We just go in, they do an internal brace in there. It's like a month recovery and you're good to go. So I'm like, all right, cool. So I started riding in a month afterwards, and my thumb was hurting me, and it just, like, was worse and worse and wasn't getting better. And yeah, I was dealing with that going into the season last year, and it was just really bothering me. I actually ended up having to get another surgery on it after my shoulder surgery, but everything's pretty good now. And we're on the right track. So just trying to take care of my body a little bit better than maybe I have in the past. Like, I've always known that you need a stretch and stuff, and I have stretched, but not with the purpose that I'm doing that stuff with now. That was a long answer.
No, that was a perfect answer. That was okay. The thumb, same hand or a different hand?
Yeah, it was same hand. Oh. The same hand as the thumb, as the wrist. Like, the doctor down, I go to a doctor at Andrews Institute, and he said that he's never seen someone that, like, builds as much scar tissue as I do, like, after a surgery or something. So actually, after the second thumb surgery that I had, he sent me home. You know, normally I would be in, like, a splint for 7 to 10 days until they take the stitches out. But he sent me home in just a wrap, and he told me that the next day I needed to take the wrap off and start moving it, just to not let that scar tissue build up. It's been a frustrating couple years. You know, just, like, these injuries that shouldn't be anything have turned into season-ending injuries.
Mm-hmm. When you live here, you live just a few miles away, you've lived here more than you've lived in your own home, and things like this happen, do you get so frustrated when you have to hear these stupid dirt bikes all day?
Yes and no. I enjoy, not that I've done it a lot, but I will come and kind of help train from time to time and stuff like that. And over the last few years, I think I've really, I don't know if it's humbled me or what, but I've really enjoyed trying to help out some of the guys that, you know, be A-class guys and really, you know, tell them what it's like moving to the next level in pro and telling them, you know, what it takes and that we have a great program here at MTF, but, you know, you have to do everything with 100%, you know, attitude going forward and, you know, give all your effort into each workout, each day on the track, each lap on the track. You know, if Colleen and Brian tell you to focus on something on the track, say it's your upper body over the front mowers, like you have to focus on that. You know, you have to do those things because everyone now is training at a training facility, you know, and they're all pretty good. And so it's made it a lot harder to, you have to work that much harder at the training facility you're at to make it to that next level and succeed there.
Yeah. Right now, your Reeves team is a Supercross only team, so you have a limited amount of time to really make a big impression. Is that put pressure on you, or is it okay because you know you have the Aussie Supercross season later on in the year that you get to do that? There's racing that's going to happen, but you're not going to have that same May to September hype for 12 weeks like other guys are going to have. Is that all good?
Yeah, it's definitely a little different. You know, not planning on racing outdoors this year. We may go and do a couple races still. So I think that I'll still be riding throughout that time. And I think that that's the biggest thing for me. It's just like if I get to ride throughout the whole summer, I haven't raced outdoors since 2018, I think. I raced, I think, three of them in 2019. And so it's like not racing outdoors is you don't get that, those like 7 months of riding or whatever it is, you know, like in that, during the summer and the off season. And then you go straight back to a Supercross track and you lose that speed. So as far as the pressure goes though, like over the rounds of Supercross, I don't feel, you know, any more pressure because of that. I mean, Yarif's been awesome and, you know, I just know that if I ride to my potential, then I'm going to show everyone what I got anyway. So,
what I'm about to say, please don't take this the wrong way because I mean it in the nicest way possible. You just said you hadn't really done the Outdoor Nationals since like 2012. We all know that these other seasons have been 18. Sorry, you know. I'm thinking 2022 already. To have these things happen, do you ever look at like, oh my gosh, these massive parts of my career are gone? This time I'm never going to make back up. My early 20s have been spent this way. Or is it because you've been down here and you've seen other guys go through these things and the group of people you have around you, you're able to be like, no, that's just what life is right now?
Yeah, I've been pretty level-headed throughout my injuries and stuff. I think I don't really get too down or try and dwell on, you know, missing races and stuff. It does suck knowing, you know, that I could be out there battling and showing what I got and I can't. But I've tried to make the best of it, you know. I've never thought about it as, you know, I'm missing out on these parts of my career, really. Whenever you get hurt, the work doesn't stop as far as, you know, you're constantly going to physical therapy and in the gym twice a day and so many different things to get ready for the next season that, you know, I'm still putting in the work. It's just different. So I haven't ever really thought about it as missing out in parts of my career.
Okay, good. I like to hear that because there are certain guys that get kind of up and down, especially when things don't go the way they thought they do. To hear you say, no, that stuff doesn't really bother me the way that it could is a huge deal because that just gives you so much more to build into the next thing. You understand the challenge. You understand what's going to happen and what you're doing it for. I talked to Mitchell Oldenburg about this a lot, and this is something that even when I went to Australia with your Reeves team in like 2019 and saw how good Mitchell is and knowing that like, hey, on any given lap, he could be one of the fastest guys. On any given night, he could be in the mix for a podium, a win if everything goes the right way. You're the same dude. You have just as much speed, just as much skill. If everything goes the way you know it needs to go, you're right there. How does that feel to have that confidence in yourself? Like, on any given night, I'm one of the best guys.
Yeah, I mean, it's really cool. You know, in 2017, 2018, you know, there was times whenever we would not be happy leaving with a second place. And that's it's a cool feeling. It's a different feeling, you know, especially because after this weekend, I got fifth in Dallas and I was pumped with fifth, you know? So it's funny how, you know, things change as far as your outlook on, you know, and your goals and stuff like that. But yeah, I mean, you know, whenever everything's clicking and you know that if you go get a start and you ride your best 15 minutes plus one lap, that you're going to be battling for the win, you know, that's a really cool feeling. And, you know, there's so many guys, you know, nowadays that have that same feeling sitting on the line, you know. I mean, there's 6, 7, 8 guys in the East Coast this year that whenever we're sitting on the line, like, we all think that we have a chance to win that night, you know, and only one guy can win. So there's still so many things that have to go right to get that, and it's pretty crazy, like, whenever you think about it, like, how many times I felt like I was the best rider on the track that night, and, you know, you don't win, whether it's a first turn crash or, you know, or you slide out or it's just a bad start, you know. So and to think that I've won 3 races, it's just crazy how much has to go right that night for you to win. Whether you're the fastest guy or you're not the fastest guy, so much has to go right.
Hey, dude, enjoy this year. It's awesome to see you back. It's been fun to hang around here the last 2 days and just see the vibe. I even joked with you yesterday. I'm like, when we did some moto tip stuff, I'm like, well, you're going to be running this place pretty soon anyway. Like 10 years from now, I'll probably send my kid down here and he'll get some Jordon Smith coaching.
Yeah, maybe.
It's a possibility. I don't see you leaving. I mean, you are so ingrained down here. Like you said, you've been here for like 15 years.
Yeah,
is that unbelievable to you?
It is. It is pretty crazy. It's crazy whenever I just think about, like, you know, the people that were here whenever I first started, and then the people, you know, how many different, you know, like, groups of friends I've had here and stuff. It's pretty crazy, and it's and there's so many of them that, like, that are my best friends now, you know, that I talk to every day and stuff. And so it's really cool. And you know, a big part of me being here for so long is just the confidence that Colleen's had in me and the belief that she's had since I was a little kid, you know. Whenever I came here, there was no reason for her to really believe that I would ever be a decent pro, and she did believe in me from the first time that she saw me ride, and you know, she's always had my back. Same with Big Brian and Little Brian. They've always had my back, and you know, they've always done a really good job. You know, if we need something as far as the track goes or whatever, Big B and Brad are out there. You know, they Daytona track, they rented an excavator, they made a full Daytona track, you know. They're switching up some lanes of our Supercross track, you know. They're constantly making this place better, and you know, Colleen has a really good connection of doctors and everything that we really have everything we need here, and it's been, you know, really cool. Colleen's like a second mom to me, and same with Big B, is like a second dad, and Little Brian, you know, he's been my trainer for 15 years now, but he's like a brother to me. So it's been really cool.
That was the perfect brochure commercial read for MTF. Yep. You did it.
I did it. Perfect.